Hello and welcome. My name is Denzel Rodriguez, and you are watching The Finance Geek, where we talk about velocity banking, infinite banking, and kingdom authority. Kingdom authority, what does that mean, right? Like, you know, I've never heard of this concept before. Building a kingdom, having authority over your life. My whole mission is to help mothers reestablish. Okay, not create, but reestablish. Okay, rebuild, restore your kingdom authority in your household so that you can influence your children, your husband, okay, the people around you to master their authority by you teaching them love and you mastering your personal finances. Okay, you have been given a gift, Mom. And I want to expose that gift. I want to share it with the world. And so let me be a vessel. Let me be an opportunity for you to dive into this YouTube channel, gain a lot of information and knowledge in a short period of time so that you can become completely debt-free, master your personal finances, establish tax-free assets, build a business, and solidify your kingdom. In the name of Jesus Christ, okay? So, every now and then, I'm going to be making videos where I just simply pour and give value to the viewers, the clients on my channel that watch, you engage, you comment, you like, you subscribe, you're committed to your finances, and I will look through different questions, things that come out to me that I'm like, oh yeah, that's a good one. All right, so I got a question from Michelle. She says, hello, Denzel. If you are making your chunks, right, your chunk payments every 6 months, then are you still paying your regular mortgage payment each month during those 6 months? Okay, simple answer, yes. Please. Everyone watching, if you're brand new to the velocity banking concept, how it works, all that good stuff, when we are practicing velocity banking, when we have determined all of our numbers, your current situation, one-on-one, when you're working with me, and we've mapped out a plan where, okay, you're going to make a chunk roughly every 6 months. The idea is that chunk payment. Let's say we're in, right now, as I'm recording this video, I'm in the month of July 2019, okay? And if I decide to make a chunk in July towards a specific debt, let's use the example here, a mortgage, okay? That chunk payment, which is a lump sum of money that we are going to put towards a debt, all right, that amount needs to cover the actual monthly payment in that specific month or even the following month. Because sometimes we'll make a chunk payment towards a debt that we already made a payment on for that specific month. So when we make a chunk, it'll apply towards the following month's payment, right? So maybe August. And we've got a principal-only payment that's going towards the mortgage. Okay, this principal, that chunk, right? So part of our chunk pays the monthly payment, whatever month we're in, or maybe the following month. And then the other bit, the rest of that money is straight principal. This money is going straight towards the debt to knock down the interest rate and all that good stuff. Now, since that was principal, that does not satisfy the following month's payments. Okay, so no, we're not satisfying 6 months worth of payments. We still have to make those payments. If you're wondering, oh, how the heck do I make those payments, Denzel, if I just threw a big chunk of money out of my debt tool to, right, wipe out a big piece of debt? Where's the cash flow to support that? All right. When we're doing velocity banking, where we're dumping all of our income into the line of credit, understand that income, let's say you make $5,000 a month and your mortgage payment is $1,500. for that specific month, listen closely, for that specific month, that $1,500 payment in July or August, you no longer have to worry about. That is temporary cash flow towards the line of credit. So now I've got all my $5K per month going into the line of credit, and only X is coming out now to pay my bills. I don't have to worry about that specific month that I made the chunk in to pay that mortgage payment. It got paid by the chunk. Now, when we go into the next month, right? Let's say August, let's say I made a chunk in July, it satisfied July's payment. So I don't have to worry about that $1,500 from my income. My line of credit was leveraged, it took care of it. All my income went into the line of credit, satisfied the monthly payment there. Took expenses out, kept cash flow in. Going into August, right? That $1,500 from July that I would have paid for in July, that $1,500 income from July is now being applied in August. And now I've got August income with August, that monthly payment. Guess what? That $1,500 is getting applied towards September. So we're giving ourselves a little bit of a boost here. Meanwhile, we're drastically lowering the balance of that chunk that we took from the line of credit, so that 6 months from the original chunk date, that initial chunk, we're making that next chunk and we restart the process and we keep going over and over again. And every time we make a chunk, we're either increasing our cash flow or saving a ton of money on interest, right? And knocking out a bunch of debt. So I hope that helps, Michelle, and everyone else watching. My name is Denzel Rodriguez. I hope you have a wonderful day, and God bless.